Australians are doing their bit to help in Lebanon following the horror blast that's left 158 dead and more than 300,000 homeless. Some have extended their trips to volunteer on the streets of Beirut as our government pledges a further $3 million in aid.
A shockwave broke this fragile city.
Honestly, I don't have any words to describe how bad it is here.
But it's now being swamped by a second wave of support. Aid workers handing out food, water, basics to the hundreds of thousands of people now homeless and hungry. Sydney lawyer Priscilla Zaytouni is volunteering with Australian-based charity Lebanon Abroad. They're stitching up wounds because hospitals are overwhelmed.
Everything is needed. There's medical supplies, we need building supplies, we need engineers. Buildings aren't safe, they're crashing as I speak.
Beirut's desperate pleas have reached every corner of the globe. Scott Morrison joining forces with around 30 world leaders to raise more than $400 million Australian dollars in just a few hours. The aid will be delivered directly to the people of Lebanon, not its leaders.
The best way to sum it up is that it's breaking your heart, but at the same time it's filling your heart to see the way the people are coming together. And we're very touched by all the support by the Australians.
In an instant, people's lives and livelihoods were torn apart. This video was filmed by a paramedic moments before she died. She was at the scene of the fire that would suddenly explode. None of the first responders stood a chance. Priscilla was due to fly home this week. She's staying on to help the masses.
The only thing that makes you forget how bad it is how amazing the people of Lebanon are. If I tell you, we have people coming from outside of Beirut, from areas that are poor themselves, with no jobs, no money, and they're coming and they're donating their own food, their own water.
Sophie Walsh, Nine News.